हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू यूज इफ एल्स लैडर। इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट एंड टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इफ एल्स लैडर। एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट इफ स्टेटमेंट इज यूज फॉर टू चेक वन कंडीशन। इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट इज यूज फॉर इफ द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स देन एल्स स्टेटमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी एग्जीक्यूट। When we want to check more than one condition, at that time we have to go for the next statement is if else ladder. Here we are going to check more than one condition. So, as the definition of if statement, if the condition is true, then it will execute inside the body of if statement. If condition is false, then it will go for else statement. This we have learned. Now, here the definition changes little bit. So, if the given, there are So, here we are checking more than one condition. So, the definition changes little bit. If condition 1 is true, statement 1 is executed. Otherwise, it will check the condition 2. Here you can see condition 1 is true, statement 1 is executed. If condition 1 is false, then what we are checking here? We are checking for the next condition. So, the same thing, it will check the condition 2. If this condition is true, then whatever you write in the statement 2, that is going to be executed. So similarly, I can add condition 3, condition 4 up to condition n. If it's considered, this is the n condition, condition n. If nth condition is true, statement n is executed. Otherwise, as a definition say, if condition is false, then you will go for else part. Here also, if else statement is false, then you will go for else condition. So, this is the method of using if else ladder. Why it is called as if else ladder? Because if first condition is false, then you will check the second condition. If second condition is false, then you will go for up to n condition. Wherever the condition is true, that particular statement is executed, it comes out from the other statement. So you will see on it how it is working on flowchart. So we have taken three condition flowchart. As our condition starts, if condition 1, it is true, statement 1 is executed, and direct it comes from the statement just below if statement, that is last statement, then we are going to exit our program. So if the condition is false, you can notice if condition is false, then we are checking the condition 2. Then the condition 2 is true, statement 2 is executed. If condition 2 is false, condition 3 is going to be checked. Statement 3 is. So you can say condition 3 or condition n up to n. So you can check same way. At the all the conditions are over, the last will be the else statements. So else statement is going to be executed. Then after if else ladder, some other statements are written that we call statement just below if. Then your program is ended. That is main end, main start. So this is the flow chart for the if else ladder. Now we will take one example on if else ladder. Now we are writing C program for largest of three number using if else ladder. As the program name is largest of three number, so we will add three variable to it. Three variables are declared. Next, these variable has to be initialized so that you will add printf statement. So we are done printf statement. Enter the value for ABC. Next, you will write scanf statement. So, how many variables are there? Three values. So, that you have to write 3%D. So, then comma, three variables, ampersand A, comma, ampersand B, comma, ampersand C. See, these are the three variables we have declared. Once the variable is declared, next we have to go for if statement. If, so we written the logical AND operator here. If A is greater than B and A is greater than C, if both the conditions are true, then we are the statement written inside the if statement is executed. Print A is largest. Assume, suppose we are entered A equal to 5, B equal to 6, C equal to 10. So condition 1 is A is greater than B, that is 5 is greater than 6. Condition is false. If the given condition is false, then we have to go write condition 2. How to write the condition 2? You have to write else space if. Then condition 2 is what we are going to check. A is smallest. Now we will check B is greater than C. We will check B is greater than C. Now we write the condition 2. Then after. Then you write the same statement as written the printf statement. So we will copy this one and we will paste it and we will replace A is largest is there, then you will write B is largest. So here according to example, the third statement is going to execute. Second condition is also false. If, then we are going to for next part is else. Else we will write. Again we will paste it. Here already we got A is largest, B is largest. If both are not largest, by default C will be the largest. So this is the program for largest of three numbers. So just we are taken the example for identification purpose for writing the three codes, condition 1, condition 2. If suppose now we will execute and you will see the output. So in that example we have taken C is equal to 10, that's why it is printed C is largest. In the value A as 15. So now what it has to print? A is largest. Now you can see A is largest. This is a program for largest of 3 number. This is using if else ladder. If you like this video, if you are having any doubts on it, you can make your comment. I will clear your doubts on your YouTube channel. Thanks for watching this video. In our next video, we are going to learn about nested if.